grabe ng cancer. Welcome to our integrated project presentation. Our project topic is on modeling and simulation of solid oxide fusion for marine application. And our group member, we have Dan Sekitari and myself, Donatian Yosu. So our slide presentation is based on two main parts. Firstly, we talk about the system mathematical modeling, and the next part is the computer simulation modeling. So just a brief introduction about solid oxide fuel cell. A solid oxide fuel cell is an electrochemical energy conversion device that converts hydrogen and oxygen into electricity, heat, and water as a result of chemical reaction. It is operated at high temperature, which is range from 600 to 1000 degrees Celsius. And it is also produced a DC power electric from fuel and oxygen by an electrochemical process. From figure 1, we can see the fuel cell diagram, which is composed of the three main components of the fuel cell, which include the cathode, electrode, and anode. From the cathode, the oxygen is reduced by the ion, oxygen ion, and through the electrolyte, the oxygen ion travel, which react with the hydrogen fuel cell at the outside, which is produce the electron, producing the electric current, and the rest is the waste, which is the excess fuel and water. For the first part of the presentation is based on system modeling. So the dynamic model of the solid oxide fuel cell is basically implemented in the MATLAB, which is based on those equations. So the solid oxide fuel cell is a nonlinear system because the output is not stable. And from this, we have the equation of voltage, the output voltage fuel cell, or the fuel cell, which is described as Inness equation minus the activation voltage minus the concentration voltage and the ohmic voltage. So from the equation 2, you can see the Nernst equation, which is basically depend on the partial pressures of hydrogen, partial pressures of oxygen, partial pressures of water, and also the flow rate of hydrogen and the flow rate of oxygen. The activation voltage equation, the question is also depend on the temperature and the current density, IFC. The concentration voltage is basically depend on the value of the temperature and IFC, which is the current density. Ohmic voltage similarly is basically depend on the value of IFC. For the system variable and parameters, the system variable and parameters include the partial pressures of hydrogen, partial pressures of oxygen, and partial pressures of water, and also the temperature, current density, and the output voltage. Based on those parameters, the model has been carried out, and the simulation output has been carried out also. In here, we have the theoretical calculation when assuming a current density is 3 amps. So for the theoretical value of Inest, we have applied the equation, and as a result, we obtain the value is 124 volt. Similarly, for the activation and ohmic loss, the activation voltage is given by this formula, and from this we obtain the value, which is 0.00334 amps. Similarly, ohmic voltage, this formula is given, and after applying a current of 3 amps, the value obtained is 0.076054. And in here, a calculation of concentration voltage is carried out, and which is 0.0154. As combined all those laws, the value of the output voltage is calculated based on the formula Inest voltage minus concentration voltage minus the ohmic voltage and minus the activation voltage, which is gives us 1.1454. We now move to our next part of our presentation, which is will be presented by my colleague Jensen Tan.
Okay, regarding the system simulation, computer system simulation, this diagram shows a general diagram of the model. The model consists of four components as shown. The first one is a Inest model, activation loss model, the concentration loss model, and ohmic loss model. And also the system has three inputs as shown here. We have a current density, the fuel, and the temperature. And the system has a serial voltage, which is a voltage. Now, based on the simulation model of activation loss, and this graph is obtained as shown, and the graph shows that the activation loss voltage decreases while the temperatures increases. And from this graph, we can also see that, for example, a test graph, the blue line, which is simulated at low temperatures, and the low graph is simulated at higher temperatures, which is the voltage is decreased. Another type of loss is that a spin model is a concentration of voltage loss, and this loss usually occurs at a high current density, as we can see from figure 4. As the value of current density increase, and similarly, the curve of the model is increasing exponentially with the current density. Another type of losses is ohmic voltage. This ohmic loss is due to the internal resistance of the electrons that flow inside the field cell. And this loss has a linear relationship with the current densities as shown in this figure. And similarly, this loss has simulated at various temperatures as shown here. Now, combining voltage loss the next equation, and the graph is one, and this graph is known as a polarization curve as shown in this figure. And from this figure we can see that the current starts to increase from zero, and there is a drop in voltage, and this drop of voltage is known as activation loss. asta care a stat impris pentru a se temelești, dar tras și cam însă bine, which is a result of coming jos. At higher current densities, this is where the concentration loss occurs, and the voltage which is decreased to zero. And from this graph, you can see that the voltage and the current density increase with increasing the temperatures. For example, the graph, the blue line, which is simulated at low temperatures, in this case, which is 873 K, has a much lower voltage with the current compared to other graphs. To conclude our presentation, this project is based on the modeling and the simulation of solid oxide filter. And the model has been implemented based on several laws as discussed earlier. And also result from a simulation of shows that change in input parameters such as temperatures and fuel also affect the polarization gap of the power. That's all of the presentation. Thank you.